John saw Jesus coming toward him and said, "Look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. The Lord be with you."
And also with you.
The light has come into the world. Come, let us worship the Lord who was obedient to death, even death on a cross. Father, when your Son hung on the cross, he cried out to you in agony and grief. You gave him the strength to endure so that death might be destroyed and life restored. Have mercy on us all our days and preserve us in true faith until life everlasting. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
We continue with hymn 98.
Jesus,
Our first reading is recorded in Luke chapter 23. As they led him away, they seized Simon from Cyrene, who was on his way in from the country, and put the cross on him and made him carry it behind Jesus. A large number of people followed him, including women who mourned and wailed for him. Jesus turned and said to them, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me. Weep for yourselves and for your children. For the time will come when you will say, 'Blessed are the barren women, the wombs that never bore and the breasts that never nursed.' Then they will say to the mountains, 'Fall on us,' and to the hills, 'Cover us.' For if men do these things when the tree is green, what will happen when it is dry?" Two other men, both criminals, were also led out with him to be executed. When they came to the place called the Skull, there they crucified him along with the criminals, one on his right, the other on his left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." This is the word of the Lord. We join in the spoken responses. All we like sheep have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way. He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shears is silent,
so he did not open his mouth.
He poured out his life unto death,
and was numbered
for he bore the sin of many. We sing hymn 397.
Thank you.
Our second reading is recorded in Luke chapter 23. The people stood watching, and the rulers even sneered at him. They said, "He saved others. Let him save himself, if he is the Christ of God, the chosen one." The soldiers also came up and mocked him. They offered him wine vinegar and said, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There was a written notice above him which read, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at him. "Aren't you the Christ? Save yourself and us." But the other criminal rebuked him. "Don't you fear God," he said, "since you are under the same sentence? We are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus answered him, "I tell you the truth. Today you will be with me in paradise." This is the word of the Lord. "But I am a worm and not a man. All who see me mock me. He trusts in the Lord. Let the Lord rescue him. We continue with our next hymn, hymn 110, verses 1 through 4.
Thank you.
Our third reading is recorded in John chapter 19. When the soldiers crucified Jesus, they took his clothes, dividing them into four shares, one for each of them, with the undergarment remaining. This garment was seamless, woven in one piece from top to bottom. "Let's not tear it," they said to one another. "Let's decide by lot who will get it." This happened that the scripture might be fulfilled, which said, "They divided my garments among them and cast lots for my clothing." So this is what the soldiers did. Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother there, and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, he said to his mother, "Dear woman, here is your son." And to the disciple, "Here is your mother." From that time on, this disciple took her into his home. This is the word of the Lord. Dogs have surrounded me. A band of evil men has encircled me. I can count all my bones. He was despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows. Like one from whom men hide their faces, he was despised. We continue with hymn 105, verses 1 through 4.
Thank you.
A reading from Mark chapter 15. At the sixth hour, darkness came over the whole land until the ninth hour. And at the ninth hour, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of those standing near heard this, they said, "Listen, he's calling Elijah." One man ran, filled a sponge with wine vinegar, put it on a stick, and offered it to Jesus to drink. "Now leave him alone. Let's see if Elijah comes to take him down," he said. This is the word of the Lord. My God, my God, why are you so far from saving me? Surely he took up our infirmities,
and carried our sorrows.
Yet we considered him stricken by God,
smitten by him, and afflicted.
But he was pierced for our transgressions,
he was crushed for our iniquities.
The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, We sing hymn 125.
Thank you.
reading from John chapter 19. Later, knowing that all was now completed, and so that the scripture would be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I am thirsty." This is the word of the Lord. I am poured out like water,
and all my bones are out of joint.
My heart has turned to wax. My strength is dried up like a potsherd,
and my tongue sticks to the roof of my mouth.
We continue with our next hymn. A reading from John chapter 19. A jar of wine vinegar was there, so they soaked a sponge in it, put the sponge on a stalk of the hyssop plant, and lifted it to Jesus' lips. When he had received the drink, Jesus said, "It is finished." With that, he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. This is the word of the Lord. All the ends of the earth will remember and turn to the Lord.
And all the families of the nations will bow down before him.
For dominion belongs to the Lord.
And he rules over the nations.
Posterity will serve him.
Future generations will be told about the Lord.
They will proclaim his righteousness to a people yet unborn. We continue with our next hymn. A reading from John chapter 19. Now it was the day of preparation, and the next day was to be a special Sabbath. Because the Jews did not want the bodies left on the crosses during the Sabbath, they asked Pilate to have the legs broken and the bodies taken down. The soldiers therefore came and broke the legs of the first man who had been crucified with Jesus. and then those of the other. But when they came to Jesus and found that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. Instead, one of the soldiers pierced Jesus' side with a spear, bringing a sudden flow of blood and water. The man who saw it has given testimony, and his testimony is true. He knows that he tells the truth, and he testifies so that you also may believe. These things happen so that the scripture would be fulfilled. Not one of his bones will be broken. And as another scripture says, they will look on the one they have pierced. Later, Joseph of Arimathea asked Pilate for the body of Jesus. Now Joseph was a disciple of Jesus, but secretly, because he feared the Jews. With Pilate's permission, he came and took the body away. He was accompanied by Nicodemus, the man who earlier had visited Jesus at night. Nicodemus brought a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 75 pounds. Taking Jesus' body, the two of them wrapped it with the spices in strips of linen. This was in accordance with Jewish burial customs. At the place where Jesus was crucified, there was a garden, and in the garden, a new tomb in which no one had ever been laid. Because it was the Jewish day of preparation, and since the tomb was nearby, they laid Jesus there. This is the word of the Lord.